Hey traders, David Frost, LazyGapTrader.com. In this video, I'm going to show you three examples of morning gap trades from this morning that worked out for profits, and I'll even show you one on Facebook that worked out after hours, after the market closed yesterday, after Facebook reported earnings. It's the same process that any trader can learn and take advantage of this strategy each and every day for the remainder of their trading career. Before we get into the charts, and you see a sneak peek of one of them on the screen now, Tower Semiconductor, TSEM. We'll get into the charts in a second. First, let me explain exactly what this gap trading strategy is all about. As day traders, we need opportunity. We need stocks to be moving to give us the opportunity to make money each and every day. But the real opportunity exists when traders can identify specific price levels where these stocks will be first drawn to like a magnet and have a price reaction from in the other direction. And these stocks I'm referring to are the ones that are gapping higher or lower at the opening bell, whether it's from an earnings report or some other news-related event. We don't really care. All we care about is that stocks are moving. If they're moving, we can identify the highest probability price level where these stocks would have a price reaction in the other direction. So as a result, I teach a course where traders learn everything they need to know in order to trade the gaps successfully. Which stocks does it work the best with? What are the criteria we're looking for? What type of volume do we need to see on these stocks? How much of a gap higher or lower in the morning are we looking for in order to qualify for one of our morning gap trades? How do you trade them? What's the profit target we're looking for? What's the stop loss limitation that we need to have? And there's a whole host of other things, but here's the holy grail. Traders that take the course learn how to calculate and identify the specific price levels where these stocks will first be drawn to like a magnet and then have that price reaction from in the other direction. And that, my friends, is where the money is made trading the gaps. Now, before we get into the specific charts on the specific trades from today, I want to explain the other thing I do, which is give traders an opportunity to get my gap trade sent to them each and every morning at 9 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Here's a copy of the email that showed up this morning, as you can see, right to the inbox at 9:01 a.m., and that's Eastern Standard Time, 30 minutes before the opening bell even rings. Now, this morning, we had a pretty extensive laundry list of opportunity on the board this morning. We're right in the heart of earnings season, and the trades come fast and furious. We had a dozen trades on the board this morning. Now, don't get scared away by the amount of opportunity. They're not all going to hit their specific price levels identified. And the way it works is we're only interested in taking the trades that do hit the specific price levels outlined first thing in the morning. So traders that have taken the course understand we just have to monitor price. And when price begins to come close to the target area, that's when we begin to impact or affect a trade. If price doesn't come close, it's off the board, it's a no trade, we don't worry about that specific opportunity. So let's take a look at the details behind the three trades that did hit their price targets this morning. The first one was Tower Semiconductor. You saw it on the screen already. We're going to go back to the chart in a moment. TSEM, I say gap lower, support levels are $20.27, and I gave another price level if the stock should continue lower. Now these are separate and independent trading opportunities. So we could take a positive trade, make money at 20.27. Later on in the day, the stock could come back down to 18.33, for example, and produce another trade. That happens more than you would think. Stop and profit target is about 25 to 45 cents. Keep in mind, these are minimum profit targets. I'll get more into that when we go back to the chart. The second trade that hit its price target today was 3D Systems. DDD is the ticker. Gap lower, support levels are $12.76, $11.60, and $10.43. Stop and profit target is about 15 to 30 cents. It's a lower price stock, so the price target is slightly lower than the norm. However, again, keep in mind, minimum profit targets, and you'll see more about that when we go to the chart of 3D Systems. The third one that hit its price objective today was Mohawk Industries, MHK, gap lower. Support levels are $183.76 and $175.80. Stop and profit target is about 60 cents to $1.20. We'll take a look at the chart of that one as well. And then just for fun, let's not forget about Facebook. Gap lower, support levels are $168.35. And then I gave two secondary price targets. Stop and profit target is about $1.25 to $2.50. Again, this is a minimum profit target. We'll take a look at Facebook real quick towards the end of the video. I'll show you exactly what happened after the earnings announcement last night. So we're back on the chart of Tower Semiconductor, and you can see what happened here. Last night, the stock closed at $23.19, all the way up here. Now, the stock was getting hit pretty hard at the open. It was trading down, and it continued to trade lower. Look what happened when it came into our price level at $20.27. You can see here that the stock made a low of $20.15, slightly below the 2027, and look what happened after that. The stock immediately took off to the upside, made a high of $21.13, and guess what? That represents an 86 cent maximum gain, or 4.2% on a $20 stock. That's a pretty good day trade. In fact, that's a great day trade. In fact, it was more of a scalp trade because it all happened in the matter of minutes. It happened within a half an hour from the entry price. Now it's coming back down. We don't care. We're out of the trade. And by the way, traders who take the course learn how to maximize these trades. They learn how to turn these trades into risk-free, emotionless trades. There's an entire video module in the course that teaches this strategy. The second one we'll take a look at is DDD, or 3D Systems. Now you can see where the stock closed yesterday at $13.96. The stock was getting a haircut at the open, came into the $12.76 level, went slightly below that level, right about up against the stop loss limitation, but immediately reversed, and look what happened with the stock. I don't have to say any more. As you can see, it had a tremendous rip higher, making a high already of $13.81. That represents over an 8% gain within the day. Forget about within the day, it was within the morning. Another tremendous morning gap trade on our hands. Now, the third one we'll take a look at was MHK, Mohawk Industries. Yesterday, the stock closed all the way up at $217.45. The stock was getting creamed at the open. We identified a level of $183.76. You can see what happened. It's pretty crystal clear. The stock came into that level, bounced right off that level. In fact, let me take the chart down to a shorter time frame so you can see exactly what happened and when. So here's a 1 minute chart. You can see what happened. The stock came into the level and then immediately had a bounce higher off that level, making a high of $187.31. That was a tremendous gain for a scalp trade that lasted only a matter of minutes. In fact, this one was 8 minutes to be exact up to that price level. Now here's the chart of Facebook, and I've brought up the after hours session so you can see these different color bright red bars. That represents the aftermarket activity from yesterday. This is when they reported earnings and the stock got absolutely creamed, as everybody already knows. But remember from the morning email, the price level was $168.35. So look what happened. The stock came all the way down from an all-time high over $218 a share, all the way into $168.35, slightly lower, and look what happened. And this all took place in the after-hour session, a rip higher all the way back up to about $185. The point is that these price levels that traders learn how to calculate for themselves when they take the course at Lazy Gap Trader, they work over and over and over again. This is a strategy that you can use for the remainder of your trading career each and every day. The last thing I'll leave you with in this video is, and I think it's the most important thing that this strategy is based on, traders learn and understand the why behind the strategy. Once you understand why this works, you have a different expectation when price comes into these specific levels, these specific price levels that you learn how to calculate calculate in the course. Once you have a certain expectation of what's likely to happen at these price levels, and keep in mind, nothing happens 100% of the time, but it sure does happen way more often than not. Once you have this expectation, you have a different outlook on trading, and it takes the guesswork away from trading. When you remove guesswork away from trading and you add back in confidence because you have a certain expectation at these price levels, it changes your trading for good. And that's probably the most important thing, other than how to come up with and calculate these price levels. That's probably the most important thing that traders get out of this course, is taking away the guesswork and adding back in confidence. And that's what we need as traders. We need confidence that we have the right price to make the right trade at the right time. If you want to learn everything there is to know about how to trade the gap successfully, come over to check out the course at Lazy Gap Trader. This is a strategy you can use each and every day for the remainder of your trading career. I'm David Frost, Lazy Gap Trader. Thanks for tuning in, folks.